We were playing hide and seek and I hid in a barrel. At first, the other kids were making noise, but then it got quiet. I got sick of sitting here and I decided to crawl out. The boys took away my shoes and I can't get along without them. Bring them to me, please. Here, take this. It's the most valuable thing I have.
Thank you. The residents decided to destroy the road to Emmett's home. They placed dynamite and blew up the bridge which led to his residence. As Mayor David Oldman said,
"We destroyed the bridge leading to this house so that no one would suffer from this horrible house and its monsters. And once again, peace and quiet will reign in our town."
This is Dr. Thomas Hamilton. I remember Emmett begged him and offered him any amount of money, if only he would help save Margaret. But the doctor didn't even come to our house to examine her. I don't want to believe that Emmett has embarked on such a dark path, but the death of two of his enemies cannot be a simple coincidence.
I remember how happily they lived here. Annie was like a little adopted daughter for Emmett and Margaret.
Go look for my friends. I see you are on your way to the wizard. They say he is very dangerous, although, to tell you a secret, we often sneak around there and we haven't seen anything terrible. Here, take this. We found it on the square in front of the wizard's house. Perhaps it will come in handy.
This is John Sedman, police commissioner. Emmett told me that he had noticed the commissioner following him. Then Sedman summoned him for an interrogation and tried to accuse him of all kinds of terrible things, but he couldn't produce any evidence. I think John Sedman aided the expulsion of Emmett from the town. Everything is becoming more and more confused. But my forebodings are being confirmed.
Quite old. I love to come here and listen to the birds, but today I fell asleep. Kind fellow, do a favor for an old lady and I will reward you generously. A girl named Annie lives nearby. She promised to give me a recipe for a good medicine for memory. Bring it to me, please.
Thank you.
Even when Emmett had already left town, the residents didn't leave him in peace and kept insulting and cursing him in every way possible.
Jack Lindman managed the cases of the families and children. He was in charge of all the schools and even took an interest in the private lives of the families. Lindman got involved in a lot that wasn't his business. He immediately joined those against Emmett. It was largely due to him, which caused Emmett to lose his sister. Lindman instigated the court hearing at which it was decided that Emmett's sister must be given away to be raised. I remember how happily Margaret and Emily had lived together. It is sad to see what came of this.
Thank you.
Annie lived here after she was taken away from Emmett. Her aunt and uncle forbid her from corresponding with Emmett. They claimed he was a mean and terrible person, but he was no longer a threat to her. Annie nevertheless kept in touch with her brother. She would defend him in every way to her aunt and uncle.
Thank you so much. You've saved me. Here is the promised reward for you, and don't wrinkle your nose. Don't argue with my experience. This thing will come in handy for you.
Thank you.